Welcome to Caseback Watches. My name is Tim, and in this episode, I'd like to speak about something suspicious. But before we do this, I have the pleasure to announce a winner from the last giveaway. The Zelos Hammerhead went to the United Kingdom to Gavin, and he had luck, and he has also those wrists which can handle such a big watch. And so congratulations, Gavin. I'm really glad that you like that piece. And amongst all those entries from the giveaway, I think it was around 360, I found an email by Luke Vanders, and he's an artist from Montana, United States, and he sent me this artwork you see here, very interesting, named Father Time Breathes. And this is somewhat mixed media with charcoal and other ingredients, and it shows a mechanical watch movement. So thank you very much for this impression here. And now to today's topic. I have an idea for the channel, for a video series I'd love to produce. Nearly every week somebody sends me an email with a watch, vintage watches, new watches, and then the guy or the lady has something in mind, feels that there's something suspicious, something's wrong with the watch, something. Is it a fake? Is it a frankenwatch? Is it something other, something fishy? And those people ask for help then. And normally I cannot answer because it's too time consuming. It's just too time consuming. You have to do your research. So I answer here and there. But some emails and some cases are really interesting. And so I thought, why not create a show called Watch Detectives? And then I present you here a case on this channel in a video, a case with all informations I have, and I deliver you my guess, my theory, what's wrong, or is it legit, it's not legit, and then you can contribute your knowledge, okay? This is the idea behind it. It's not the watch detective, it's the watch detectives, it's you. And I think this could be very entertaining. We could learn so much with it. And it would create a nice service to people who have their little vintage treasure and they're not sure. And so this means that you can use the email address casebackwatches@icloud.com to present your case, to ask for help. And of course, this is free. I don't want to charge a fee. This would be not realistic, to be honest. But important, of course, is that we can do this only with watches you really own. We cannot grab just images from a shop and then we make a massacre with that watch. This would be really a troublemaker. So we can only discuss watches when the owner gives his okay. But then I think we have a very interesting opportunity. I don't want to make this every week, but when an interesting case pops up, I present it, I give you my thought, my opinion, my guess, then you add your contribution, and then in the next video the problem is solved. The case is solved and we have a lucky owner of, let's say, a vintage watch. And I have an example, a real example. I received a mail from Jason, also United States, and he bought a Jaeger-LeCoultre Memovox. This is the watch he bought. And he asked me if I think this watch is legit, if there's everything okay with it. And I studied those images and I thought, no, absolutely not. My stomach tells me that here is something badly wrong. And I told Jason, I cannot prove this, of course. I need the reference number, I need more information. But my guess here is something here is wrong. And then we try to find a solution. We try to find some clues here. And then I thought, let's present it on the channel and let's see what other people know about it. Okay, here we have our watch. Jason bought this watch from a small shop in his town and from a shop owner who wasn't into vintage watches, who wasn't into watches at all, very limited knowledge about watches. But what we see here at first glance looks good. We have the watch, apparently 60s, we have the box, we have the outer box, everything is marked with LeCoultre instead of Jaeger-LeCoultre. Because back then, Jaeger-LeCoultre used only the term LeCoultre for the market in the United States. So if you have a vintage watch named like this, it's very likely it was sold first in the United States. Jason was told that this watch was owned by an US senator. And there I thought, okay, we have a watch with a nice story around it. This seems tempting, but also could be something like a trap, to be honest. And so, yeah. And here it goes on. Here you see the warranty card. It's blank with nothing on it. So it could be a warranty card from another watch, basically. Or for this watch. I mean, everything is possible. And I don't say that this watch is fake. I don't say that it's a Frankenwatch. I don't say that I am 100% sure that there's something wrong. But all those points here are a bit too suspicious, if you ask me. And the watch was in need of a service, and so Jason paid $200 for it. So very little money for such an iconic watch. The first thing I've found a bit strange is, of course, that the logo is on the inner disc. The inner disc is rotating when you set the time for the alarm. Normally you find the logo from Memovoxes on position 12, like here. This is an example Jaeger-LeCoultre Memovox, so sold in Europe. And this means, of course, that the logo is never crooked in such a way here. The second thing is the dial color. Yes, this might be. I mean, there are so many reference numbers out there from Memovox watches that might be that they produced such a watch with that color. But it's not typical in my eyes. Then the next point is the red color on the hands and on the indices, especially on the minute hand. And also this black, it looks really, really rough. It doesn't look professionally applied. And I cannot believe, to be honest, that this could pass a quality control in Switzerland. Next point is that the minute scale seems to be uneven. I mean, it's hard to tell only with images. It might be patina, but I'm not sure. I could imagine that this was done carefully by hand. By the way, the example you see here, it's also a reprinted dial. Look at the index on position 5, the minute index. It's too fat. And this is then the end. And then you can see that the logo is slightly crooked. And this is also the end. This is a reprint. Next point is that I found that the case reminds me in a very strange way of another case, of a Rolex case form you see here. This is a Tudor day date from the 70s, and you see the resemblance is striking. So an indication for Frankenwatch? Not very likely, despite that resemblance, because there are two crowns and the case back looks legit. Here you have the case back, and this looks pretty original. This looks like a GLC vintage case back, so nothing to complain here. Here's another example from a legit case back. The sign in the middle is polished away, but you see the overall shape and form is there. And here you see the case back inside, and this is a bit disappointing, but the gentleman who took this image had a very basic phone, and so we have only this image, and we cannot spot, or at least I cannot spot, the reference number here, and that's what we need. We need the reference number to see if all those details are trackable. The movement also a bit disappointing. We can see that it's marked with LeCoultre, but we cannot see the actual number of the movement, and this would be, of course, very helpful in combination with the reference number. Here you have a legit Jaeger-LeCoultre Memovox movement, and you may note that there is a resemblance how they executed the major parts. And so I highly believe that Jason's movement is legit, but this doesn't answer the question, is it in the correct case? Is it in the correct reference number? And so this would be the task here, to find out the reference number, find out the correct movement, put it all together, use Google Image Search to find the watch from a legit, or let's say trustful, source, and then you could say if there's something wrong with the watch. And so my guess here is that we see here a, let's say, rare reference, but original, made by Jaeger-LeCoultre, but this dial here is repainted, I think. I really think this is not original. By the way, during the video production, during editing, I had a lunch break and I took out my Elgin from the 50s, tiny watch, gold-plated, but with some garments, some coats, some jacket, it really shines outside. And so yeah, I was very happy with the piece. And now let's go back. Okay, and now it's your turn. Please let me know what you think about this idea, watch detectors from time to time on Caseback watches. I know the idea right now is still a bit rough, so we had to develop terms and conditions. Then you could find them always in the description, so that we're on the legal side here. This is very important, especially on YouTube. But when we make this with some cautious and some brain, I think then we have a very interesting show here. Very interesting show with a lot of potential. And I'm already a bit excited about it, as you can see. And so I'd love to do this, but I don't want to make it alone. I need viewer participation here. Otherwise it would be very, very difficult. And so please leave a comment, subscribe to the channel if you want to know how this idea develops. You can visit me also on Instagram, caseback_Tim, or use the email address casebackwatches@icloud.com. And now let me thank you very much for your attention, and until next time.